bad, not bad actually. Let me turn it off before I get a copyright strike, right? Alright, so today's video is about those things. Those. Yamaha NS10 speakers. And I think if you ever seen some studio pictures, not of my studio, but general studio pictures, you recognize those white cones immediately. You'll see them in every studio around the world. It's maybe one of the most popular studio speakers there is. And why? Well, it's a great speaker because it sounds horrible. Or well, that's what they say. I do have my own opinion about it, but that's at the end of the video. So how did the NS10s actually came into the studio if it's such a horrible speaker? The NS10 actually wasn't even a studio monitor to start with. The NS10s were actually for consumers, a bit of hi-fi type consumers, and were never planned to use professionally. And they were made in the 70s. But then the 80s arrived, and there are a lot of tales on the internet about how they actually came to the studio. But it has to do something with the fact that in the 80s, engineers were allowed to bring stuff to the studio and bring more and more stuff to the studio. It was really handy for them to take their own speakers to the studio because they then had a reference. And of course, it was not only the NS10s they took with them. They were different speaker brands. But the NS10s stayed because of one little feature. And that is because they translate really, really well to the outside world. And they are almost brutally honest. So why are they so honest? What is wrong with those speakers? Well, for instance, the white cones are super stiff, so they are really hard to move, if you can say it like that, and they are not really elastic. And what I mean with that is, well, if a cone moves for instance a sine wave, it moves like this, and the sine wave suddenly stops, the cone will still resonate a bit until it's back at its center position. And the more stiff a cone is, the less it will resonate. It's actually pretty simple logic. So they are way more accurate in terms of timing and in terms of transients. Yeah, a bit sharp. It's a bit painful in the ears. And you will quickly notice that when you listen to them, that they are really, really snappy and really on point. They sound pretty accurate, strangely enough. So what do I think of those? Well, I've tried them for a while now. They are not mine, by the way. They are from a friend of mine. I borrowed them together with an original Yamaha amplifier. It's a really great set, these. And you know, when I first set up those speakers in here and you know, gained it and connected everything up, I've listened to some simple charts music, like Billboard stuff on it, actually, because I was testing and, you know, why not? And they sounded super annoying to my ears. Like the kind of annoyance you have when you have mixed too long on a too high volume, like a bit pain in your ears, and that you really wanted to go home. And I personally have that after like 8 or 10 hours of studio work. I really am done with it. On the NS10s, 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, I was done. My ears were, well, not bleeding, but it wasn't a pleasant experience. So then I stopped, I walked away, got some coffee, got my ears to rest, and then I came back and then I listened to some properly mixed music, which sadly isn't in the charts right now. Daft Punk, Toto, Michael Jackson, that kind of stuff. And then it became interesting because that wasn't annoying in my ears. It really wasn't annoying me. It was super pleasant to listen at. And the interesting thing was, when I switched over to my big Philipses, my modified custom Philips, those two. When I switched to them, it's difficult to explain. Of course, the sound changed. The sound changed a lot. But the feel stayed the same. The balances stayed the same. The way the sound field, everything stayed the same. Only the sound character and sound color, of course. But everything stayed the same. Whereas in those chart music, those Billboard music tracks, on my big speakers, they still sounded reasonably good, you know, they were still enjoyable. And on the NS10s, they weren't. So clearly something wrong there, because they say if it doesn't sound good on an NS10, then you still need to work on it. And then I got some of my own work and tried it out on the NS10s, because I was really curious if I was already up to the NS10 standard. And luckily, I was actually pretty satisfied with my own work. And I think that has mostly to do with the fact that I'm using those mix cubes, and I actually use them a lot. And those mix cubes actually do the same kind of thing. They are also pretty stiff. They are really built in a worst case scenario way. They are actually if you ask me, like the thought out version of the NS10s, like this is the goal we want to achieve, like make a worst case scenario speaker for the studio, and this is how we're going to make it. Well, the NS10s are more built on coincidence. Like, coincidentally, the NS10s were like worst case scenario speakers, were really great speakers to check your mix on. So I tried the NS10s to see if they have something to add to my studio. And will I buy them? Will I add them to my studio? And my answer to that is yes, but not right now. It's not high on my wish list. It's way at the bottom. Because they are really cool speakers. I think they are classics. They actually belong in the studio. But since I already have my mix checkers, my mix cubes, they only can add like maybe 1%, maybe less than 1% to my overall workflow, sound quality, and most of all speed, because mixing decisions are made a bit faster on the NS10s, maybe. And also because, well, this is kind of, yeah, not a cool thing, is I don't have any room to put them. Right now they are not in an optimal position. I need to move my head forwards, like I need to listen over here to have the correct triangle. They are really not in a great position right now, and in order to get them in a great position I need to lay them down on the bridge of my console. But the Aventones are already laying, and it will also interfere with my mains then. And the only way to get out of this is to finish my big console. It's over here, it's really like it's looking at me, which has got a big bridge on which I could lay them by then. But that one looks like it will never get finished. Yeah, still a lot of work to do and a lot of waiting to do, because yeah. With that being said, the Yamaha NS10s, if you ever get a chance to try them out or to buy them, or if you really want to add something to your speaker setup, I really recommend the NS10s, or the mix cubes of course, but NS10s do have a little bit more of that. Yeah, you know, there's a bit more soul in that story, and a bit more, you know, they have proven themselves, whereas the mix cubes are pretty new. That's actually what I wanted to say. So yeah, check them out if you ever get the chance. And thanks a lot for watching this video. I hope you liked this video. It's not a normal video for my channel, but let me know what you think of this. Let me know what you think of the NS10s. Check out the Sound on Sound article below. And I will see you guys again in the next video. Bye bye. Bye bye. Hey, that's a different sign. Bye bye, rock and roll.